In this video, I'm gonna share my settings for the Lumix S5 camera. Hi guys, my name is Matti Sulanto. I'm a photographer and a Lumix ambassador. And in this video, I'm gonna share my settings for the Lumix S5 full-frame mirrorless camera. And the reason I'm sharing my settings is that you might like my settings and you might also find some settings or customizability that you didn't realize your camera had. At least it has happened to me many, many times that when I get a new camera, I'm just so happy to start using my camera that I don't necessarily realize all the features and the customizability that my camera has. And then about 2 years later, I realized that I could have customized my camera much better right from the start. So let's get started and see how I set up my Lumix S5 camera. And to be clear, this is not about any specific settings that you choose when you take pictures or shoot video. This is about how to set the dials, buttons, and the menus. Before I do anything on any camera, any new camera that is, I turn off all the beep sounds because they are just too annoying to me. And on the Lumix S5, you can turn off all the beeps by going to the spanner menu, then choose in and out the tab or sub menu, and then choose beep. And there you can turn on or off all the beeps that you like. And then I'm gonna set the dials, because those are the most important controls on any camera, except for the shutter button, of course, which is probably the most important control or button on any camera. But the dials are essential to control the camera when you're shooting. And on the S5 camera, you go to the cog menu, then choose operation, the first page of operation, and then choose dial set. And there you have several options. First, you have 5 sets of dial functions. I like to choose the set 5 because that is the most logical to me, and I like to have my shutter speed on the rear dial and my aperture on the front dial. And the next option is the control dial, which is the dial on the back of the camera, and there I choose the ISO. And then I have my aperture, shutter speed, and ISO each on a separate dial, which is really, really nice and makes it very easy to set each value when I'm shooting. And now that I've set the ISO on the rear dial, then I will go back and choose the rotation for these two top dials. And I'm gonna choose the second option, because then whenever I turn the dials away from the viewfinder, my image will go brighter. And whenever I turn any of the dials towards the viewfinder, my picture will go darker. So that's very logical behavior to me. And that's how I like to set my dials. And then I'm gonna set the exposure compensation on the top rear dial that I operate with my thumb. And after that, whenever I'm on any of the automatic modes, the front dial will select the value, the rear dial, the rear top dial will select the exposure compensation, and the back dial on the back of the camera will select the ISO. And next, I'm gonna set the function buttons. And they are pretty good as they are by default. But there are two buttons that I'm going to change. The first is the front button right by the lens. I'm gonna set the operation lock on that button. And I'm using the operation lock whenever I shoot videos so that I don't accidentally change any of the settings when I handle the camera. Again, you go to the cog menu, operation, first page of operation, and function button set. And there I choose the rec mode and find my button and set the operation lock on that button. And the other button I'm going to reprogram is the ISO button. I don't need that anymore because my ISO is on the rear dial. And I'm going to assign the waveform monitor on the ISO button. That is only for video use, but I like to have that available whenever I need, and I want to be able to switch it on and off whenever I want to very quickly. And to assign the waveform on the ISO button, you again go to the cog menu and choose the first page of operation and function button set and rec mode, and choose the ISO button, and then find the waveform monitor / vector scope and choose that. And that's it. I don't touch any of the other function buttons. They work well for me as they are by default. And next I'm gonna set up the My Menu, which is really handy because inevitably there are some features that you're gonna be using on a regular basis, and it makes sense to have them readily available. And to set up the My Menu, you first go to the My Menu and choose the pen symbol and add. And then you just start browsing and add whatever functions or features you want to add to the My Menu. And after you've added all the functions you want, and then you can sort or organize them and even delete some if you added too many. In these two screenshots, you can see how my menu looks on the Lumix S5 camera. The first page is here, and the second page is here. Please feel free to pause the video if you want to take a closer look. And the next is the Q menu. And on the Q menu, I like to have some features that I use all the time when I'm actually shooting or taking pictures. And one of the great things on the S5 and all the S series cameras is that you can have a different Q menu for photo and video modes. And it's really, really nice because at least I want to have totally different items on the Q menu when I take photographs, and then totally different items there when I shoot video. And here's how to set both Q menus. Again, go to the cog menu and then the first page of operation, and there on the top you can see the Q menu settings. And first you can choose the style, whether you want the traditional style that was used or is used on the Micro Four Thirds cameras, or whether you want the new style, the Mode 1, that is used on the by default on the S series cameras. And then you can select what the front dial is doing, and then you can customize photo Q menu and video Q menu. And on the photo Q menu, I like to have the photo style, the aspect ratio, minimum shutter speed, and then the autofocus point moving speed, and focus peaking, and zebra pattern on and off. And on the video Q menu, I like to have these following settings. I'm just gonna scroll through them, and again, you can pause the video if I'm going too fast. Exposure mode, file format, video quality, photo style, AF settings, stabilizer settings, focus peaking, sound level display, sound level adjustment, zebra pattern, Wi-Fi, and image area. And the last but not least, I will set the creative video combined set. And what it means is that I can select which specific settings the camera will remember when I go from photo mode to video mode, and then back to photo mode again, and back to video mode again, and so on and so on. And to do that, you will first go again to the cog menu and then select the image quality, the first one on the top, and then the creative video combined set. And there you can select which settings the camera will remember in the video mode or photo mode. And I have chosen everything else but the metering mode, because the metering mode doesn't mean anything to me. So now when I turn my camera to the video mode or photo mode, my camera will remember my exposure settings, white balance, photo style, and autofocus mode. And this is really super handy if I switch back from photo to video and then back again and back again and so on. That's it. That's how I customize the Lumix S5 camera. I hope this video helps you to customize your S5. And even if you don't like the exact same settings that I'm using, I hope this video helps you to find new ways to customize your S5. And also, don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't done that already and tap the bell, so you'll get a notification every time I post new content. And thank you so much for watching again, and I'll see you in the next video.